Hello everyone, my name is Vikash Shukla and in today's video I will speak about the buying at dips for the stock market. I had done a video earlier about buying at dips and I had touched upon some of the points, including, and it's just very important, how to keep it diversified and how keeping some fund reserved for it, using methods like home equity line of credit or some any other way, reserve and be prepared for if the market goes down scenario, to be able to take advantage of this method. And it's in practical scenario, it may not always work, but if it does, it's a very good strategy, and it requires some kind of discipline. For example, that opportunity may not come to you. That tip that we are talking about may not come to you, but if it does, to an extent, it can profit you. And in today's video, what I'm going to do is talk about the concept of the weighted average, and that requires a level of discipline, which frankly, I have not been able to take advantage of. But I think if we could discipline, and I have taken profit in some situation, but not always, it can be very good. So the concept is this. Let's say the currently our S&P today is at about the almost all-time high at 3300, and it's possible that this stock market can go down. Maybe this from 3300 could go down to 3000, 2700, and let's say 2400. We'll not cover the case where it goes below 30%. And then you have individual stock. Even if this S&P as a market as a whole does not go down, some of the stocks that you own could go down. And I expect that they go down, but they do not go bankrupt. And they eventually go up after going down. So that's the scenario. And because some of the stocks may go down bankrupt, the concept of the diversification that I have covered in another video. The thing that I'm going to mathematically show you is the concept of weighted average. And if you remember, I quickly mentioned that I typically allow the stock to go down to like 10%, and then I buy it increased quantity. So for example, if I buy 100 share here, it goes down like 10%, I buy 200 shares of it in 2x quantity. And then it goes further down by another 10%, I buy at 3x quantity. So that's the concept of the weighted average. So when you are staying here at like 100 share, then you should keep the money, and that's let's say a $10 share, you're buying the share at $1,000, and you should keep this much of money available for you, which is 9 into 2, which is like $1,800 plus $2,400. You should have that money, that much of money in reserve, either by loan or by stockbroker's loan or by home equity line of credit or whatever way. You should be prepared for that. So the formula for this weighted average, how do I calculate at the end of this scenario, what is the average price of my share? And this, because I'm buying more at the lower price, more quantity at the lower price, the average is not at the center. It's more towards the lower side. It's closer to 8 than to 10. So the weighted average is going to be 10 into 1 plus 9 into 2 plus 8 into 3 divided by 3 plus 2 plus 1, which is 6. And if you do the math, this 18 plus 24, it's 42 plus 10, 52, divided by 6, it's 8.66. So this is your average price of one stock. It's towards the lower end of this thing. You are here. And now I'm considering the case where the stock starts rising up and you wait. You wait till it crosses your first buy point. It goes all the way up to $11, And if you sell all your stock at that price point, then your profit is going to be 11 minus 8.66, which is $2.34 for each stock. In terms of percentage profit, that will be 2.34 divided by 8.36 multiplied by 100, or you are looking at 27% of the profit. Now let's compare this case with where you, that's what we typically all have to do. We buy a stock, if it goes down, we say, okay, just wait and watch. Don't do anything, just wait and watch. And if we do that, we buy it at 10, we sell it at $11, our profit is 10%. What we are here doing here is, we are buying the stock with all the money that we have, and then we sell all of them at $11, we get 10% of profit. Or we could do a simple averaging, which is probably maybe the case when you do not have that much of money available with you in reduced, when the stock price is going down. Then your average buying price is 10 plus 9 plus 8 divided by 3, or $9. In that case, let's say you sell it when it goes back to $11, you make a profit of $2, and your average, your percentage profit in that case will be 2 divided by 9, or about 22%. It is still much better than not buying the stock at the dip and then keep doing the drawing down, reducing your averaging down. But still, weighted average is still a bit better. So at the minimum, try to do a simple averaging, and if you could do weighted averaging, that's even better. So this is the math behind the buying at the dip, but be cautious about it. The stock could be headed all the way down and it could go bankrupt. And that's why you do this averaging only with the good companies you know about. They have at least some history in the past. And the second most important thing is diversify it to at least 3 shares. If it's more than 3, even better, but at least 3. And the reason for this is, if one of them goes bust, let's say one of them goes bust, becomes zero, you have other 2 stocks making 27% plus 27%, 54%. And that probably will take care of the other stock that eventually goes bust. So this is my idea. You can create your own Excel sheet, do some simple calculation, and create a predetermined strategy and stick to it. I hope you will make a lot of money in the stock market. Thanks for taking a look.